In the United States, you go and talk to a business and you're like, hey, look, okay, you can process your payments with Lightning. You can use OpenNode, or you can go above and beyond and you can have your own BTC Pay server and all this and manage all your liquidity and everything. But these businesses are like, well, why? I accept cards. I'm privileged, I guess you could say, in the grand scheme of the world. Like, I accept cards. I don't even know how much I'm getting charged to process these payments. But it's just the cost of doing business. So they're a little more reluctant, but it's almost like having to retrain these businesses here in the States, and tell them, look, accepting, like I say, financial ones and zeros, just financial data, does not have to be some great cost of doing business anymore. Like, what Visa and MasterCard and these payment processors are charging you to process your payment, Lightning does for free. So it's almost like a retraining thing here in the States. But in El Salvador, I go up to them and I go, hey, you want to use digital payments for like the first time ever? And it sends for free? And they're like, sign me the fuck up. Like, they're like, yeah, let's do it. Oh, do you want to set up your own online store, run some promotions? And they're like, yeah, absolutely. Like, I could sign them up in minutes. So it's really wild, the contrast. And I almost look at it as, let's say, like, we need like a return to normal, right? So in El Salvador, they still operate mostly on cash. Like, I mean, in Bitcoin Beach, like, you're using Bitcoin over Lightning. Like, it's great. But generally speaking, I mean, they use the dollar and they're paying in cash everywhere, right? And they just haven't had the opportunity to upgrade to digital payments. Whereas in the United States, we now use digital payments, but we've gotten like so far away from the norm. Like, now, cash payments don't, inherently have a processing fee, right? It's peer-to-peer. Like, Bitcoin opens up that same peer-to-peer, digital cash, right? Without the fees. And so it's like the United States businesses have to revert and kind of like relearn, like, no, let's get back to the norm of like a peer-to-peer, now digital cash, right? Whereas, so they're having to move back. It's weird for them. Whereas the people in El Salvador and other countries, as they slowly, adopt Bitcoin, like, they're moving forward. It feels very, very, like, progressive for them, as opposed to regressive for businesses in the U.S. So it's a stark contrast, but I think there's a lot to learn, by talking with businesses in both jurisdictions.